Swaraja, in collaboration with India Foundation and Indic Book Club, has instituted Swaraja Awards to recognize individuals and institutions doing stellar work in various walks of life. While being largely committed to advancing values like open market, freedom of enterprise, national interest, innovation, entrepreneurship, and celebrating the richness of India's vast cultural heritage. Four awards encompassing economics, politics, society, and cultural spheres will be presented. The award will carry a citation, a trophy, and a cash prize of 1 lakh rupees. The winner of Dr. B.R. Shenoy Award for Economics is Sri Niranjan Rajadaksha. The reason why I feel proud to present this award to Rajadaksha is his commitment to classical liberalism. He did not bow down to the pressure from the intolerant left media barons in giving a free and fair voice to all political views. In an era where bigotry masquerades as liberalism, such truly committed intellectuals stand out not just for what they write, but also for the ideas that they support.
It will be an honor to get this award, which is named after B.R. Shenoy, who is one of my intellectual heroes. The other thing is that I'm a product of the Mumbai School of Economics, and my professor, P.R. Brahmanand, was one half of the Brahmanand Vakil duo, which also challenged the planning consensus of the 1950s. So in that sense, this award also has a lot of personal meaning for me. So thank you once again.
The Ustad Bismillah Khan Award for Culture goes to Sirivennela Sitarama Shastri Garu. Sirivennela Sitarama Shastri Garu's poetic and purposeful contribution way beyond the 3,000 lyrics that he has penned for the Telugu film industry, there's little doubt that his literary skills are legendary and that he unveils a lush tapestry of human emotions in each and every song he creates. This year's Ustad Bismillah Khan Award by Swaraja Magazine is but a token of recognition of his stellar contribution to both the literary field and to the way he inspires the youth to live right.
I feel very happy and privileged to have been selected for this prestigious Indian Foundation Swaraja Award. Both the words Indian Foundation and Swaraj are part and parcel of my DNA. It's very simple and natural expectation that it should be the case with every Indian. Unfortunately, today the words Indian and Swaraj are used apologetically. I believe with strong desire and determination to cry halt to this suicidal tendency, the organization of India Foundation is founded and working. I strongly feel that this award is not given to a person, Sitaram Shastri. It is given to a persona. It is in recognition of my core personality which is nurtured from infancy till date by our great ethos and ethics. I'm sure there are many more people who feel lucky to have been born and brought up in the lap of this great culture. I consider myself a representative of all such people who are in the path and protection of this indomitable way of life, and therefore I accept this award with pride and pleasure and dedicate the same to the community of worshippers of this culture. The greatest of the visionaries of this era, Dr. Hedegaard, used to be annoyed and angry if someone refers to him, or for that matter anybody, as a patriot. Because he used to say, rightly so, that it should be a natural trait of anybody and everybody to be a patriot. It should not be an external or additional attribute. Similarly, every Indian should naturally feel proud to be the heir of this great culture. If someone or some section or some group shy away from this natural trait, it is the responsibility of all of us to restore the trait by strengthening the hands of Indian Foundation. Namaste.
Dr. S.P. Mukherjee Award for Politics goes to Sri Himanta Biswa Sarma. Assam, till Himanta Biswa Sarma arrived on the scene, was one of the worst performers amongst all the states of India in health and education sectors. After becoming the health minister in 2006, Sharma brought about revolutionary changes in the sector, by not only vastly improving and augmenting the government healthcare infrastructure, but also by streamlining the delivery mechanism and making it totally responsive to the needs of the people. Sharma is a highly efficient administrator who sets goals and works relentlessly towards achieving them. And that is why he has, ever since his first term as a member of the Legislative Assembly in 2001, been given the charge of important departments. Sri Himanta Biswa Sarma receives the Dr. S.P. Mukherjee Award for his extraordinary contribution to the state of Assam and for his heroic efforts towards the development of Northeastern region.
Ladies and gentlemen, I am indeed honored to receive this award from Swarajya. More so because the award is named after a stalwart of not only the Indian independence movement, but also the founder of Hindu Mahasabha, Sri Shyama Prasad Mukherjee. Sri Mukherjee laid down ideological foundation of modern day Indian politics, sacrificed his life for the unity and integrity of India. We in Eastern India are certainly grateful to him and beholden to him for this effort. I also fondly remember our own Assam Sri Gopinath Bordoloi, who has prevented our region from becoming part of erstwhile East Pakistan. Thus, I am indeed humbled to receive this award, and I receive this on behalf of the people of Assam. Assam, as you all know, is facing a very serious demographic divide that threatens to tear the social fabric of the state. Assam faces a grave civilizational threat because of the unchecked illegal migration from foreigners from across the border. This illegal influx of foreigners that started decades ago have been encouraged by successive governments in the past due to petty vote bank politics. I am sure that had Shyama Prasad Mukherjee not died an untimely death his Kashmir immediately after we get independence from British rule, he would have definitely mobilized public opinion across the country against this illegal influx and created a very strong movement in the rest of the India against demographic invasion faced not only Assam but also all Northeastern state and West Bengal from East Pakistan, which is now Bangladesh. The Assam government, which I am part of, is committed to identify and deport all illegal migrants from our soil, and that I believe will be a fitting tribute to Shyama Prasad Mukherjee. This award, the Shyama Prasad Mukherjee Award for Politics, is an honor that I accept most humbly. The politics that I pursue is and has always been based on the inalienable principle of public goods and welfare for all. The teachings of Gita, our civilizational heritage, and the spiritual tradition of our country has formed the basics of my politics, which is to me nothing but a forum for serving people to the best of my ability. I thank India Foundation for providing this forum and Swarajya for bestowing this prestigious award to me. Jaya Ayakam, Bande Mataram.
Sri Narayan Guru Award for Social Work goes to Srimati Lakshmi Narayan Tripathi. Lakshmi Narayan Tripathi, eminent transgender rights activist, author, and dancer, has shaped the India's gender discourse to lend it the essential third dimension. Tripathi's efforts, meaningful activism, and her radiant presence in India's evolving LGBT narrative have been instrumental in providing the transgender community recognition and the dignity as a third gender. Tripathi has placed India on the leading edge of an identity discourse that was compelled to take the shape of a revolution owing to our cultural disconnect from Bharat. Swarajya is proud to honor Lakshmi Narayan Tripathi with Sri Narayan Guru Award for her contribution to India's Kinnara community, gender discourse, and Dharma.
I believe it's an honor to my soul and for my entire community, because I represent one of those people in this world which is the only sexual minority which is visible. And I used to always say I belong to the Hijra community. There are many names, right from Anusmriti to so many other religions also have created so much names for me. But the destiny, I represent the oldest ethnic transgender community in the world, which are known as the Kinnars. Mughals came, they took away our religion, they took away our whole institution, what we were there in India. Britishers came, they tried to wipe us out. India got freedom. But we, as Indians, only got recognized in 2014. I believe this is for the first time, sir, that any transgender would be in this country after independence would be receiving any kind of appreciation from one of the highest offices by Vice President of India or anywhere. We won the Supreme Court verdict. Later on, the irony is still that I was born in a Hindu Brahmin family. My parents belonged to Gorakhpur. I was born in Maharashtra, Thane. Studied there, recognized my gender, started social activism in a fun way, like only just to say that my sisters were dying with HIV AIDS and we didn't have any medical aid. From there, reaching to United Nations, representing the entire Asia-Pacific region at the United Nations General Assembly President's Office on its Civil Society Task Force. Then winning the Supreme Court verdict. And now the irony in India is that we are still fighting to get our akhada. We established the Kinnar akhada to regain our lost position in the Hindu culture against the 13 akhadas existing, the akhadas. Community chose me to be the Acharya Mahamandaleshwar. We are fighting, and of course it is not a fight, it is just understanding of religion. We were there, we will be there. We lost everything, but we never left our culture. We are as Indian as any man and woman. We are as Indian, when I always say my akhada and my people would be there to defend the country, because we have nothing to lose. We have lost everything. We lost our parents. We lost everything only to be what we were. Today I accept this award in the memory of so many hundreds of years of people who were treated invisibles. Kehte hain hamara manushya hone ka astitva jab samaj ne kheech liya. Aaj, today is a day that, you know, the winter session is starting and a transgender bill will be coming into the parliament. I really am really proud that today India has proven to the world that even it is a leader in the trans movement, and it is a leader in giving the rights as basic human rights to constitutional rights to every trans person in this country. Jai Shri Mahakal.
I'd like to thank the awardees, Lakshminarayan Tripathi ji, Dheeraj Ranjan ji, Himant Biswa ji, Sri Vennela Sitaram Shastri garu, for accepting the award, the Swarajya Awards. Your acceptance is equally important to us, and it's a recognition for us too. Thank you very much. I'd like to thank Jayan Sinha ji for your constant support, the IF family. Thank you, Manohar Parikar ji. Your last 4 years support this event has become a truly global event. Thank you very much.